It's an early morning start for the half marathon here at the 29th Summer Universiade. First up, the women, who will get going at 7 a.m. They'll be followed by the men 15 minutes later. And there's the gun. They will first head west on Renai Road. And there you see the competitors heading off. There you see competitor number 11, Fabian Amrein of Germany, next to Maki Izumida of Japan. Now to the men. So the women are on the course, the men follow. There you see City Hall right in behind. And there you see Kakana of South Africa, number 52 and 41, Muladzi, also of South Africa. Now back to the women in red, the Japanese contingent. Starting to take control here. They dominated this event back in Guangzhou, winning 5 of the 6 medals between the men and the women. Sevele Itemis of Turkey, you can see her there trying to fend off the Japanese. And later in the race, there you see number 21, Yuki Munehisa of Japan. She would pull away to win the gold medal ahead of Edemir of Turkey and Saki Fukui of Japan. There you see the winners. Now to the men, the two South Africans still there, number 39, Katarega of Uganda, and 36, Kudo of Japan. And there you see them. And again, two Japanese would pull away, Kudo number 43 with Kei Katanashi of Japan. And it would be Katanashi with the extra burst near the finish. He'll win the gold medal. Kudo of Japan will win the silver. And Kengo Suzuki, you see it there, will win the bronze. So again, 5 of 6 medals go to Japan. We now move to the University of Taipei diving pool. This is the men's 10-meter platform final. And there are the divers. We will first take a look at Kim Yong-nam of Korea. Already 3 medals here. A gold in the 1 meter springboard, silver in the 3 meter springboard, and a bronze in the 10 meter men's synchro platform. This is a back 2.5 somersault with 2.5 twists in the pike position. And a good dive there for Kim. Just a bit of splash on the entry. But he would score 91.80. His overall total, 473.85. Next up, this is David Dinsmore of the United States. Won the college title last March for the University of Miami. This is also a back 2.5 somersault with 2.5 twists in the pike position. And a great dive there. Near rip entry for Dinsmore.
The scores are 8.5, 8.5, 8.5, 8.5, 9, 9.
And just like Kim, he would score 91.80, his overall total 476.40. Now to Ri Hyun Ju of the Democratic People's Republic of Korea. Same dive as the previous two competitors. If he can nail this, he will win the gold medal. He has a silver earlier in the men's synchro 10-meter platform with Hyun Il-myung. And again, a near rip entry. A great dive there for Ree. And his score, a 93.60. That will give him a total of 491.20 and the gold medal. Dinsmore of the United States wins the silver. Kim of Korea will win the bronze. Now to the mixed team event. First up for Germany, this is Q Duong. This is a forward 3.5 somersault. Fair amount of splash on that entry for Duong. She would score a 63. Now to her teammate, Lars Rudiger. He was eighth earlier here at Taipei in the men's 3-meter springboard. This is a forward 2.5 somersault with two twists. Each of the divers must complete at least one dive from the 3-meter springboard and the 10-meter platform. And their third dive can be from their choice. This is Selena Toth of Canada. A bronze medal already in the women's platform. A lot of splash on that dive. That was an inward 3.5 somersault. She won the bronze in this event back in 2015 with Cameron McLean. Her score here, 62.40. Now Tyler Henschel, an arm stand back double somersault with 1.5 twist. Good dive. Not a lot of splash on the entry. He would score a 76.80. Now to the team from Ukraine. This is Oleksandr Gorshkovazov. A forward 4.5 somersault. And there you have the replay. A bit of splash, but a 92.50.
Anastasia Nedobiga from Ukraine.
Now to Anastasia Nedobiga. A reverse 2.5 somersault. She was an Olympian last year at Rio. Bit of overextension on the entry. A lot of splash. Her score, 61.50. But the Ukrainians would score enough to win gold. The team from Canada, silver. And from Germany, they will take the bronze. We now go to Hsinchu County Gymnasium for Wushu. This is the women's and men's Taolu Changquan. And we'll now get to the competitor from Macau, China. This is Li Yi. Taolu is a series of predetermined movements combined and practiced as a set of continuous movements. It is meant to build up a practitioner's flexibility, internal and external strength. And there are two types. With Li here, you're watching the solo form, but there's also a sparring form. And there's the performance from Li. She would score 9.51 to win the gold medal. Konstantinova of Russia would take silver, and Ayaka Honda of Japan would win the bronze.
Final score, 9.51.
And there you see the final results. Now to the men.
The arena.
16 competitors on the men's side. This is Li Mengnan of China. And again, these athletes are competing the Changquan, which is the long fist style. It comprises of styles that originated in northern areas of China, so north of the Yangtze River. And this style is defined by open and long range strikes, as well as a wide variety of leg techniques and circular motions. As you can see, it's a very fast and dynamic style. You get a good example of how dynamic and quick it is. And there, Lee completes his performance. He would score a 9.55 ahead of Pavel Muratov of Russia and Tsai Tse-min of Chinese Taipei. There you see the Taipei Expo Dome here in Taipei. And this is billiards, a demonstration sport here at the World University Games. This is the men's nine-ball pool singles gold medal match. This features Liu Chengqie of Chinese Taipei against his countryman Su Jui-an. And it's a race to 11, right now 10-3 in favor of Su. Liu would break this game, as you saw. And if Su can win this, he will win gold. The players must hit the lowest numbered ball that remains, though other balls may go down as a result of that. There you see, now two balls away from a gold medal. The eight ball drops. With a good leave, he will finish it off. There you see it, a gold medal for Su Jui-an of Chinese Taipei. Liu will settle for the silver.
各位亲爱的朋友,大家午安。主桌是蒙古,
now to the women's gold medal match. Bayar Saikhan of Mongolia taking on Ku Cheng Chin of Chinese Taipei. And there's the break from Ku. And now Bayar Saikhan trailing 8-6. She must win this game to stay alive. She misses there on the three ball, and then later on, she'll miss on the six. So that opens the door for Ku. The six falls. Then the seven, two balls away from a gold medal. And a good leave again here, and she does it, finishes it off, winning 9-6 to take the gold medal. Bayar Saikhan will settle here for silver. Now to volleyball. Quarterfinal matchups here from Taipei. First up, the Islamic Republic of Iran taking on the Czech Republic. The Czechs 4-1 in group play. That put them second in Pool C, while Iran first in Pool D with a record of 5-0. 7-3, Iran in front. The Czechs serving. From the back row, defended well there by Iran. Another back row attack there from the Czech Republic. And a good pass finds the baseline. That's Pirot with the kill. Iran would win the first set 25-14, now 20-all in the second set. There's the back set to Martin Hladik off the Iranian block and out of bounds. But Iran would get to set point, 24-23. Czechs forced to bump it over, free ball opportunity for Iran. And that one will go off the Czech block and out from Karkané. Iran up 2-0. Now 16-13, Iran leading in the third. And there's a great kill from Sultz for the Czech Republic. 19-16 now, Iran in front. And that attack from Karkané off the Czech block and out. Move now to match point. A great dig there by Fala. Iran hits it over. But the Czechs will push that one out of bounds, and Iran will now head to the semifinal. As they win this 3-0 over the Czech Republic. The next quarterfinal coming up momentarily. There you see the score here, Iran over the Czechs. And of course, take a little bit of a picture to celebrate. Now to that other quarterfinal. This is Brazil taking on Ukraine. Ukraine 4-0 in Pool B. Brazil 3-1 in Pool A. 7-5, Brazil in front here in the opening set. And NATO hits that one off the Ukrainian block and out. Now 19-14, Ukraine in front. Quick set attack eludes Lemunier, and Ukraine would go on to win the first set, 25-20. Now to the second, Brazil up big, 18-7. Free ball opportunity here for Brazil. And that quick set for De Lima. And he earns the kill, putting the Brazilians up 19-7. Now set point, that Ukrainian serve goes long. So Brazil ties it at one set apiece. Ukraine would win the third set, 25-21, now up 11-6 in the fourth. And that attack off Brazil out of bounds. Now 17-11. And that kill for Plotnitsky. He puts it away. 20-13, Ukraine now in front. Brazil not going away. Quick set there to D'Souza for the kill. Now to match point, 24-16. And there's the attack from Ukraine, and the return will sail out of bounds. Ukraine. They move to the semifinal. Well, they will take on the Islamic Republic of Iran. In the other semi, it'll be Russia taking on either Japan or Portugal. Taipei Arena, the site of two of the quarterfinals in men's basketball action here in Taipei. First up, it's Israel taking on the United States. Israel in blue, the United States in white. U.S. was 5-0 in pool play, Israel 4-1. And Kulichov opens it up with a three-pointer from Sharon. 16-all here right now. And Nogel Eastern will find Dakota Mathias. He'll drain the three to make it 19-16 U.S. Ball worked out here. Kulichov, dribble penetration. He'll find Zuchman in the corner. He drains yet another three. That reduces the U.S. lead to one. Now Carson Edwards, he'll find Mathias. He hits the three, and Haas is fouled underneath. So the basket counts, U.S. maintains possession, but Israel will be up by four at the half. Now to the fourth quarter, 73-68. The U.S. in front. There's a nice look from Ziv to Altit. And PJ Thompson with a quick three for the U.S. 6-point edge. Now 97-94 for the U.S. in front. Ziv at the line, hits the first free throw. He's got to miss the second one. He does. The rebound eludes the U.S. And Koperberg with a huge finish to tie this ball game up with 0.9 seconds, and it would go to overtime. Now in overtime. Carson Edwards comes to the ball for the U.S. And he'll drain a big three, one of his eight in the game. Now Sharon finds the cutting Koperberg. He slipped down the lane. Tied at 104. Thompson to Edwards. He'll find Mathias and some patience with the shot clock winding down. Drains another three. The Americans now up by three. They'd extend it to six. Israel needs a bit of a miracle here. Ziv, fadeaway three is good. Thompson needs to hit one to really seal it. He does at the line. 4-point edge. Israel fires one last attempt, but it will not be enough. Despite a valiant effort, the United States moves on to the semifinal with a 4-point win over Israel. They will take on Serbia in the semifinal. Now to the other quarterfinal played at Taipei Arena. Lithuania taking on Argentina. Both teams were 4-1 in pool play. Gaben for Lithuania will get things rolling with a three-pointer from the wing. 16-9 now, Argentina in front. Here's Carvalho. He'll penetrate. That shot missed, but tipped in by Gallardo. Now in the second quarter, 24-18 Argentina. There's a little pull-up jumper by Buemo. At the half, Argentina would be up 38-36. Now late into the third quarter, there's the entry to Sagis, who scores for Lithuania. Here in the fourth, 62-55, Lithuania ahead. Carvalho with the nice reverse layup. Now late, 67-66, Lithuania. Skip pass over to Dimsa. Nice shot fake, and the jumper from the short corner is good. Lithuania up three. Under 10 seconds to go, Argentina with Carvalho. Gets to the rim and is fouled. Ties it up and a chance for the lead for Argentina. He'll calmly hit it. Argentina up one. Time ticking down for Lithuania. Vaitkus loses the ball, but he gets it back. Falls away off the glass and in. The clock at zero. They'll reset it to 0.3 seconds. A technical called against the Argentinian coach. Lithuania will just have to inbound it to win, and they do. A huge finish by Lithuania. They look to be in trouble, but they will head off now to the semifinal. And finally here from this night, water polo from the Taiwan Sport University Arena. This is the women's semifinal featuring Russia and Hungary, one of the best rivalries in the world in water polo. Hungary in the blue caps, Russia in white. You see the foul in front of the net, and Greta Gurasadi will score right after to put Hungary up 1-0. And there you see on the replay, just inside that right post. 2-0 now, Hungary. And they'll work the ball here to Leimeter. And she'll skip one home to make it 3-0 for Hungary. And the Russians will talk things over. Move a little bit later, 5-0 now for Hungary. Foul in front. So from the 5 meter line, Karimova is stopped by Bolognai. Hungary back the other way, and again, skip home there. That's Zsilagyi. 6-0 Hungary. There's a foul in front by Hungary. Russia puts the ball right back there in the hands of Simonovic, who finally gets Russia on the board. 7-2 Hungary in front. There's a nice pass here late. And Chirzina with the open net. You can see that great pass. And an easy score for Russia. Here into the third quarter, 7-4 for Hungary, and Garda from long range will make it 8-4. Garda. 10-5 now, Hungary in control. Gorbunova will score though there to make it 10-6. Hungary again on the attack. Zsilagyi makes it 11-6. 11-7, time ticking down for Russia. A foul, then a no-look shot by Russia, stopped by Bolognai. Time, though, not in Russia's favor. It ticks away. Hungary off to the gold medal match. They will take on the United States, while Russia will play Japan for bronze.